on my hypnosis collection. The main collaboration was with Anthony Howe, a kinetic sculptor. His sculptures are really creating an optical illusion that is quite infinite, and that was also the inspiration behind that collection. For the show, we made the Omniverse sculpture. The whole sculpture is made of a few hundred circles, and they are laid out so precisely that when they move, you can't really tell whether they go forward or backwards. The whole sculpture starts breathing. It's a continuous expansion and contraction. That's the optical illusion. Started inspiring me to think of my own work in a different way as well. What I hoped is that you really couldn't see so much where the garment begins and where the skin ends. The patterns are cut so finely that it moves faster than your eye can follow. So it has a really delicate interaction with tiny movements of the body. So it creates like an optical illusion when you walk in it. Something that you have to look at for a longer time to grasp. One technique that was specifically done for this collection was the Suminigashi technique, where we looked at the ancient technique from Japan, where they use ink and water to create the pattern. So it's the movement of the water that creates the line work. The Infinity dress is also in collaboration with Anthony Howe, and I think the most difficult dress we ever made. The dress was made to move on wind, but of course with a show indoors it was actually motorized. So I also wanted to create again that balance where nature always needs to be in dialogue with the technology.